Yo, today on Passport Kings, I'm discussing the five most uncomfortable footwear you can travel in, but you shouldn't. Engage.
I'm Rockland. I travel the globe for leisure, exploration, and education about different cultures. Join me, and you too can be royalty.
This is Passport Kings. Welcome aboard abroad.
Whether you're on a hike up the side of the Hollywood Mountain or just sitting in a plane for 5 hours and want to remove your shoes for a little while, travelers quickly begin to realize that comfort is the most important thing going on in life from moment to moment. Comfortable sweatpants eliminates jeans, back pockets designs from hurting your butt, and an extra hoodie can stop you from freezing your cockles off when someone turns the air conditioner too high. But most importantly, what will make or break your comfort level when traveling is footwear, shoes, kicks, sneakers. You know, a lot of travelers will not take this major issue into consideration until it's too late. I, at one time, also cared more about how my sneakers looked before thinking about how much they could endure or how much I can endure with them on. Yeah, so some people posted jokes about the joints that I had on in a few of my videos, and believe me, I get the joke. Crappy looking kicks can destroy the most well put together fit in the world. That was a motto I lived by for all of my teens, 20s, and even some of my 30s. Then something happened. I got old. What really happened was I was realizing that what could have been some of the best times of my life were being ruined by uncomfortable feet. I would never say throw all of your fashion sense out of the window, because just like the first day of school, if you look good, you feel good. And when you feel good, you'll make a better first impression. But like I said, being fly sometimes has to come second to comfort. So let's just jump right into it. Number five, worst thing to have on your feet are flip-flops. I think NBA players leaving practice may have started this trend. They would finish shooting around and then they would leave really thick socks on and slip their feet into flip-flops. This look caught on with a lot of people, mainly young people, trying to emulate their favorite stars. It sounds like a pretty good idea for comfort levels because you can slide them off and on whenever you feel like it. And they are not gripping every inch of your foot all day. That is until you realize how long you've been pressing your toes down in the front of them just to walk without them slipping off. Not only that, but they look horrible, especially without the socks. This is not the way to be dressed when you meet someone for the first time. It makes you look either lazy or pretentious, as if you're mad nice and you just finished practicing it for the All-Star game. But the final straw is when they wind up being more work to keep on than it's worth. You almost wish your toes were fingers so they could grab the front and keep them in place. I'm looking to relax mid-trip, not feel like I'm playing thumbsies with my shoes. They can get some props while you're sitting in your airplane seat because of the easy ability to slip them off. But at the end of the day, some regular Nikes can be slipped off and on with no problem. So they don't even get those props. Number four, and most ugly option possible, is the sandals that strap around the back and has plenty of air holes. They look like they're made from multiple leather straps. You know what I'm talking about, the ones that the African men and the Caribbean old men wear. Being from New York, I wouldn't be caught dead in these things. These are the shoes that epic clowning is made out of. I guess the extra vents for your feet probably makes sense in hot environments, but if the environment is that hot, it probably means it's full of insects too. The last thing you need is open-toe shoes when bugs get hungry. But to be honest, the most offensive part of those shoes is how they look. And is it me, or do the people who wear these things always seem to be running the sole down on one side? I may be a lot more liberal nowadays with how I dress because I like to keep comfort in mind, as well as use the extra loot I have for extravagance when traveling. But there are still just some fashion lines that I will not cross. And those sandals are at the front of that line. Do us a favor and let's all retire them. Number three, Timberlands. Only a New Yorker would even think about wearing some construction boots on a plane and to a cool spot. Hey, what can I say? Like the Yankee cap, we could live in other cities for decades and still be stuck on our illogical New York City ways. None of us really like the Yankees that much, and hardly any of us want to work construction if we could find something that would pay the same or more. But I have worn Timberlands to other states because of the cool factor. It was only cool for a little while though. After a while, you realize how hot your feet are and how heavy boots are to walk in. Tackle the fact that no one else is walking around with boots, and the decision is easily made to never do the Tim's thing again. Not to mention trying to pack them or pull them off really quickly when in a relaxed spot. They would make sense for hiking or cold cities and countries, but lugging them around is so much work, it's not even worth it at all. Number two, Air Max 95s. Do you want to know what it feels like to have your feet pressed into a tight corner that's paved in sharp rocks? I didn't either, but I found out what it feels like when I was in Miami with a brand new pair of Air Max 95s on. Design-wise, the 95s were the flyest Air Max to ever hit the shelves. To this day, if you have a special event to go to that lets you wear whatever you want, there is no more stylish footwear for most occasions than the 95s. But the 95s have a secret. They are not shaped the way human feet are shaped. At least not my feet. The front of the shoe is too narrow. It's like all your toes are balled up in the front. Didn't make matters worse. The air bubbles that are supposed to make you feel like you're walking on air feel more like asphalt on a dirt road. I tried and tried with my Air Max. I brought a larger size. That didn't work. I pulled out the lining out the inside. That didn't work. I even tried wearing them with no laces. They are impossible to get comfortable in, so I had to do away with them. They can flatten pretty good, so they can be stuffed in luggage pretty well, which is good because if there is a cool spot to go to on your destination for only a couple of hours, Air Max 95s is the way to go in style, but just not traveling. And the number one spot for the most uncomfortable footwear, nothing beats the Foamposites. These things were not made with comfort in mind. Fly? Yes. Some of the dopest sneaker designs on earth. But when it comes to wearing them for a long length of time, there is no shoe more uncomfortable. I'd rather wear hard bottoms before I have Foamposites as my only footwear for a long trip again. At one point, I thought I had broken my ankle and needed to see a foot doctor. I couldn't understand why at my age I had a bad ankle. I was at a point where every time a new color would come out, I would go get them. And at almost $300 a pop, it was a pretty expensive habit. But one day, while wearing some other sneakers, it dawned on me, hey, my ankle ain't hurting today. I mentioned it to other people who like foams, and we all started to realize that the foot and ankle issues we were having were being caused by our stylish and freaking expensive shoe game. I've since not worn them on trips, and I haven't had any foot issues since. I still have a few pair that I wear from time to time, and I'm sure I'll even cop more if they keep coming out with the fire colors that they've been doing lately. But as far as packing them in a suitcase or wearing them on my feet for a long trip, there is no way in the world I will go for my Foamposites again. They still fly though. Yo, I want to give a big shout out to Deacon James Trustee for becoming a new patron and supporting the Passport Kings movement. From my heart, I truly appreciate your support, and I promise to keep giving you my full efforts on this Passport Kings project. Thanks, man. Yo, packing light is very important to me, and nothing kills space and luggage like footwear, and nothing kills comfort like bad shoes. Me, I prefer that the only shoes I take with me are the ones on my feet, but I know a lot of the royal family will think differently because they gotta keep up with their shoe game. Just make sure the kicks you do take will give you the ability to walk around for hours, sit for hours with them on, and won't cause you long-term effects. One of the best benefits of being royal is the comfort that comes with the crown. So be comfortable, like a king, a Passport King. Peace!